Lesson number 12, PET scans. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to describe examples of the use of positron emission tomography, PET scanning. For many decades, ionizing radiations, such as X-rays, have been used to produce images of the inside of the body. A traditional X-ray produces a shadow image when passing through dense objects in the body. These images are useful for dentistry and to show broken bones, but to see small items in the body, much more detail is needed. Computerized tomography, CT, and magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, use computer imaging rather than a picture on a film, and are able to make images which show slices of the body, tomography, with superb clarity. CT uses X-rays, and MRI uses a strong magnetic field. Positron emission tomography scans are quite different to other medical imaging techniques because they do not display the anatomy of the body. Instead, PET scans show the position of body processes. A PET scan reveals areas with high levels of chemical activity, such as high glucose metabolism. The cells in a cancerous tumor are dividing rapidly, so have high levels of glucose metabolism. The tumor then shows up on a scan as a dark region. Often, the PET scan is combined with a CT image to give a combined PET-CT image. The hot spots detected by the PET are overlaid onto the slicer's CT X-ray image to locate the areas of high metabolism precisely. PET works using a drug called a radiopharmaceutical or radioactive tracer. This drug is made by combining a chemical which will travel to certain parts of the body together with a radioactive element. The most common tracer is glucose combined with fluorine 18 and is called FDG, 2-fluoro-2-deoxy-D-glucose. Fluorine 18 is radioactive and decays by emitting a positron. It has a half-life of about 110 minutes. The FDG collects in areas of high glucose metabolism and gives off radiation. The radiopharmaceutical is injected into the arm of the patient, and in less than an hour it will have collected in certain parts of the body. For instance, the brain uses glucose as its main source of energy. Glucose will go to the parts of the brain which are most active. The radiopharmaceutical emits a type of radiation called positrons. Positrons are positively charged particles with the same mass as electrons. They are the antiparticles of electrons. The positrons collide with electrons in the body and produce gamma rays, which travel out of the body. The level of radiation is similar to that of a normal X-ray. The patient lies on a bed surrounded by a ring of gamma ray detectors. The bed can be moved through the ring. Any gamma rays passing from the patient through the ring of sensors are detected. Since each sensor points in one direction only, the computer knows which line the gamma ray traveled along. The computer produces a picture showing the position of the source of the radiation. The bed moves slightly to a new position. The gamma radiation emitted from the plane is now detected, and a new slice is displayed.